Father, in the name of Jesus, lift your hand. Father, in the name of Jesus, say, I decree. Come on, come on, I want to hear your voice. Say, I decree, I declare, by the power of the Holy Ghost. Say, I arrest every spirit of destruction, every spirit of worry, every spirit of unstableness. Say, right now, as I clap my hand, in the name of Jesus, be arrested. Clap your hand and pray. Rakataha. Branda hi katara minda hi. Ekete brahanda ha. Come on, come on, come on, come on. If you have been sleeping, wake up, wake up, wake up. It's time for the word. It's time for the word. It's for the word. The word of God will change your story. The word of God will empower you. The word of God will take you to your story. The word of God will give you a testimony. The word of God will take you to your destiny. You need the word. You need the word. Above all, you need the word. Especially in this last day, we need the word of God like never before. And I pray that you are here spiritually, physically, in every area of your life. So God can minister to you tonight. Man sat here, Abraham sat down. Hey, teach me, Lord, to know your words. That's a rare in this place. And the Lord, see if anyone can believe tonight, they're gonna be a rain. I don't know what kind of rain. Lift your hand, but that rain will be up to you. That can be your finance, that can be your marriage, that can be your business, that can be your career, that can be your school, or your career, or your resort. I don't know what kind of rain. Can I declare that before the end of this service, somebody gonna receive a rain? Receive it right now. Can you receive it? Can you receive it? Can you receive it? Receive it in your prayer life. Receive it in your spiritual life. Receive it if you believe it. Jump on your feet and catch the rain. Catch it. Somebody say catch it. I felt it. It's going to be a good day. Come on, I can feel it. Then we're going to be a good day. And high five to somebody next to you. Say, Jesus loves you more than you do. And after you do, you can have your seat. The Lord is good. The Lord is good. Who is blessed to be in the presence of the Lord? If you are blessed, wave your hand inside. Wow. Blessed. Wow. Wow. Just wave your hand to the Lord. Say, the Lord has not finished with me. Let's go to the book of Psalm 102 or 103 verse 7. Tonight, I just want to encourage you, bring your pencil, bring your notebook, put your recording stuff, turn your device off from people texting you. Let's get the word in us tonight. I believe if we can get this on Friday, it's going to be a blessing to you. The Bible says what?
He made known his ways to Moses, his acts to the children of Israel.
Do you hear that? The Lord made known his ways to Moses. But the children of Israel, he showed them the power, the glory, the miracle, but he never showed them his ways. But Moses knows the ways. Can we lift your hands? I want to know the ways of God. That's what I want to know. When I come, if I want, I don't want to know the stores in Ashburton. I don't want to know the meat factory in Ashburton. I want to know the way to get Ashburton. Because you can know all the shops in Ashburton. He can know all the stores or whatever, but if you don't know the ways, he can't get it. You didn't hear what I'm saying? He can know the, let's say for example, there's something you need from Ashburton, right? Let's say you want to buy a cloth, or maybe a car, or a house, or whatever it is in Ashburton, and he saw it online, it's amazing. But even though he saw those things, if you don't know the way to Ashburton, he may not get it, even though he can see it. So the things of God is available to us. But if you don't know the ways, you may see these things. But it's very reachable, but untouchable. But I prophesy tonight, it's not going to be reachable, it's going to be touchable. No, receive that, receive it. That's why you can see in a place like this, somebody can jump in, somebody are wondering why. Because all you see is not all there is. So tonight,
I just want to encourage you. Let us pay attention. Before we do that, can I please help me welcome you tonight? Help me to welcome you. Help me. Clap your hand properly. I'm not talking about help. Help me to welcome you. The Lord bless you. You have done the right thing to be, especially in the feast night, and where we feast the word of God. Help me to thank my wife. In the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Mom, for everything. Can you celebrate all our pastors, all our ministers, all our elders around the world? We appreciate you. May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Can we thank you for our children? They are a blessing. Children, we love you. Always we speak highly of you. Whatever the Bible says you're going to be, you're going to be. And Papa be praying for you forever in Jesus' name. Amen. And tell yourself, I made it. Now let's get ready for the word of God. I think on Friday we're going to have a Holy Communion. That's why we just want to, if you make sure you invite, I think before the end of the service, we'll have the flyer, right? So we're going to give at least everyone one flyer to bring one soul. Tell them one soul. So we're going to give everyone one more flyer and then the rest, the people that are going to go for out. Use one soul. Use one flyer to win one soul for the Lord. Huh? Just one soul for Jesus. Let's be, sometimes we can think about it, but we never do it. So we give everybody one flyer, and then the rest, the soul winners, use it, and we sow it for the Lord. Amen? At least win souls, at least a soul. Don't put it in the mailbox, give it to one person. Let's see how God changed you from those things. These things, with teaching without doing it, will not change you. When you do it, it looks simple, but the result is incredible. The things of God look so simple, but when you apply it, it's amazing. So we're having a Holy Communion and anointed service together. No, the Lord, anytime before I fly out here, I had made not just a vow, but to pray before I go, right? Remember that. So make sure you're there tomorrow. The reason why people perish is lack of knowledge. We're going to learn tonight. No, after COVID-19, many things have happened. Businesses closed, families shut down, ministries shut down, things happen. No, COVID-19 is not a spirit, it's not a thing, it's a spirit. So, but we still have to prepare for this year, before the end of this year, and for next year. We're not going to fight our battle in next year. We can fight our battle here. We can finish next year battle here. Who believe that? We can finish it here. We have to be wise, waiting to fight our battle next year. We can start now. If we don't start now, you will fight the battle, whether you like it or not. Whether you like it or not, every one of us will face challenges, whether we like it or not. That's why Jesus said, you receive this. Okay, let me say John chapter 16 before we go there. Holy Communion service tomorrow. Please, is that tomorrow? On Friday. So tomorrow we will. John 16:33, say what?
These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world.
Did you hear that? Say, these things I have spoken to you, that in me, the only place we can have shalom is in Jesus. Peace is not because I have a wife. Wife is good. Not because of kid. Kid is good. Not because of a house, a car. Those are beautiful. Remember that we appreciate our family. We love them. But that is not your peace. If you want to have a total peace, your peace is in Christ. Because if you miss that, thinking that, oh, your cat, your dog just have a puppy. What do you call it? A puppy. You're like, oh, I'm so joyful. Think again. If you think that your car, somebody says, I have a nice car, I'm just pimping my ride this Christmas, think again. You're going to have a flat tire, though, on a highway. Yeah, that's sweating like demon. Yes. Think again. But regardless of what happened, if you can have peace in Christ, can I prophesy tonight that somebody's peace is going to be returned on Christ? When you have peace in Christ, no matter what, you are secured. I prophesy that your peace is secured in Christ in the name of Jesus, our servant. No matter what, because the world we are living now not going to get better. Remember Jesus tell us, the world not going to get better in the world. You're going to be better in the men that can learn what we're going to teach tonight. The world is not getting better. The world is getting worse. The Bible shows the only way the world can be good is when Jesus shows up. When a man is born, when a man is born by the means of his mom, you are not born. When mom gives birth to you, he's not giving birth to you for you to have more life. The day you are born, your death begins. You hear that? The day you are born, your death begins. That's why you don't grow younger, you grow older until you become born again. So there's no hope in the world, but there's hope in the Lord. We have been told about this thing. Climate changing, air pollution, China, it's not the fault of China. Don't blame China. It's not China. The world is under a curse. And the only people going to redeem it, the people I will be talking to tonight. Oh yes, get ready, tell them, get ready. So we are really blaming China for everything. When you get to heaven, God says, it's not China, it's you. China what? Open the Bible, it's not in China. This is Bible, praise the Lord. I say, praise the Lord. Tell your neighbor, hear Papa preach tonight. Because something good is about to happen to you. Say, if you can cultivate it. And on this weekend, we're going to be Auckland. Remember that. Help us to share the gospel. And the flyer is on Facebook. Sometimes the Facebook, they don't allow us even to target you. Please, when you see those flyers, share, please. Help us to get the gospel out. We are praying. Our desire is not to allow people to go to hell. Because the enemy walking overnight, discouraging people, distracting people, walking overnight. People are not focused. Listen, there's a place in the Bible. I don't want to go into detail. There's a man, his name was Samson. You know Samson, the story? God told him, don't marry a foreign woman. Because his anointing was designed to destroy those foreigners. He was anointed to destroy what? Philistines. God said, don't marry from your enemy. The day God will deliver you from your enemy, but God cannot deliver you from your friends. You hear what I'm saying? God can deliver you from your enemies, but God cannot deliver you from your friends. Your friends, you make a decision. So Samson, instead of seeing them as their enemy, he married his enemy. And his enemy destroys him. When the enemy captured him, do you know what number one thing they do? They take his vision. The moment the enemy capture you, you can't think anymore. Your vision is out. You are distracted. One thing the enemy is going to do is take your vision. You are not here for prayer. You are not here for the word. He tries to make things happen. You want to make things happen. Remember, before we are born again, we are trying to make it happen. It didn't work. Jesus saved us. Now, you want to go back to old life that didn't work in the first place. Vision has been removed. And number two, they mock him. So when your vision is removed, the devil mock you. They use him as a mockery. But I pray a lot of honesty. Regardless of the shopping, regardless of the business, regardless of the things that are going on around, make sure you don't lose your vision. On that day, your friends that take you to McDonald's or take you to a place you know that you're not supposed to go, they will not stand with you. The only person that can stand is you and Jesus. Always know that. Walk with the wise. He became wise. Those people that say, I got your back, I got your left, I got your kidney, I got your liver. It's not in that place for that. I got your back is a word for unbelievers. It's not for Christians. You don't need to call anybody back. The person that got your back is the Holy Spirit. Got your front is the Holy Spirit. Got your side is the Holy Spirit. Nobody got your back. In fact, people that got your back, you better be careful, they can stab you from the back. So all this word people use, it's the worldly word. It's not in the Bible. There's no place in the Bible. The Bible says your friend will go your back. It's a prayer for one another. If you want to have a future, have a man, a woman that prays. A woman that led you to pray, I love you. A man that led you to pray, I love you. The time you are living now, without prayer, people would die like chicken. You see what I'm telling you? Anybody that encourage you to pray, show me a man that fell away. I show you a man that can pray. The moment you stop praying, your sentence is over. Prayer is the only thing that can cause us to meet where we meet with divinity. That's the only way we can authorize God to intervene on our behalf. God has no business moving in your place unless you authorize it. So tonight is a night where we cultivate the spirit of prayer. So we can become effective, especially for us mom, daddy, so we can be effective in the last day. The Bible says in the last day, people's heart will fail them. God is not lying. The heart of men will fail them. He said, men will be lovers of themselves. They don't fear anything. He said, but Bible said, don't be part of that. Because sooner they will fade away. But those who endure to the end will receive the crown of life. And you can't endure without a lifestyle of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, Jesus Christ, when he was here, he said, man, in fact, he said, my house shall be called the house of prayer. Remember when he was about to be baptized? Others were baptizing, there were excitement, they were happy baptizing. But Jesus was baptizing and praying. His heaven opened. Others people, they were baptizing, they never prayed. Their heaven will close. Can we? A prophet said that tonight, your heaven will open in the name of Jesus. So as you cultivate in the spirit of prayer, so that you can be able to be effective, focus. As we cultivate the spirit of prayer, Bob, I'm going to get a place here. 1 Corinthians 16 verse 9. So we're going to be maybe using no King James.
For a great and effective door has opened to me, and there are many adversaries.
Do you hear that? Paul tried to show us here that great and effective door has been opened to me, but there are so many enemies. Somebody's door has been opened tonight. Marriage, business, health, maybe fruit of the womb. Maybe the things you are crying for a long time. God said the door has been opened. Not just a door, effective door, a great door. Can I speak to somebody tonight? That the door has been opened. The Bible says, but even though the door has been opened, there are some enemies that resisted the door. Now, for you to be able to put them to their place is a man of prayer. So door opening is not enough. So there's the resistance behind the door. Try to stop you. Try to hinder you. So how can we be able to get this enemy out? Only prayer. Are you hearing me? Only what? Prayer. And I declare tonight that before the end of this service, somebody's door that has been opened, maybe it has not been manifest. Before the end of this service, it will be manifest in the name of Jesus. Can you receive it? Can you receive it? And then the Bible says again, the reason why we have to have the spirit of prayer. I try to show you the reason why. If you don't pray, you can never remove the enemy out of your door. You will have the feeling. You will feel that something good is about to happen, but it never manifests. And then First Thessalonians chapter 2. We just want to study tonight. Is it all right? First Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 18.
Therefore, we wanted to come to you, even I, Paul, time and again, but Satan hindered us.
Satan, look at that. Paul is a man to come to you again and again. You do have another translation? Oh, is that? Yeah.
We wanted very much to come to you, and I, Paul, tried again and again.
Again and again. Finance want to come to you. Wisdom want to come to you. Favor want to come to you. Peace want to come to you again and again. But what is stopping it? Can I lift your right hand and say tonight, nothing will stop you tonight. Say, nothing will stop it. I can't hear your voice. Say, nothing will stop it. In the name of Jesus. He said, I want to come to you again and again. Houses. Somebody applaud for us. Salvation of our loved ones. Families, friends. They're like, man, you know, I saw your life had changed. But one day I will be there. What's stopping them? Satan. They have seen your life change. They have known the person used to be before. They love the person they see now. Why can't they follow? What's stopping them? The Satan. Who am I going to be in darkness? Who am I going to go to hell? Is anyone when I'm going to hell? Nobody when I go to hell. There's some things people do, they don't want to do it, but they find themselves doing it. Who's causing them to do it? Satan. Nobody can use cigarette, try to smoke themselves to death, and they know that cigarette causes what? Cancer. Nobody want to do that. But do you see people do that? Come on, talk to me. Do you see people do that? Yes. So this is the world we live. How can you use your money? You work 8 hours a day. You work 8 hours a day, 5 days in a week. And then you use the money to destroy your life. Huh? How do you know that? You use the money to destroy your life. Can you do that? How can you work so hard and use that money for your own destruction? Is there anyone that does that? No. But that's what the enemy does. When somebody doing that, guess what happens? They're destroying their own life. They're poisoning their body. At the end of the day, they pay for it with their own money. See, that's the life we find ourselves struggling. Again and again, the enemy stopped it. But the reason for God to fight in the spirit of prayer, so we can take charge over our weaknesses. So we can put an end to pain, an end to closed doors, an end to imaginations, and live reality. Because Christianity is real. Tell anybody, this is real. So we're gonna show you tonight. It's gonna be awesome tonight. I just wanna show you that things are gonna be changing after we know this. Amen. Mark 11:22. Just write Bible verses tonight. We'll go home study. Tomorrow study. Or we are fasting. Are you fasting?
Yes.
I'm gonna finish with the Holy Communion. I know you are fasting tomorrow, so that's what we try to give you the word. So that this fasting not just be a fasting, not just be a starving, but gonna be elevation, promotion, acceleration, and something new happen to us in the name of Jesus. Uh-huh.
So Jesus answered and said to them, "Have faith in God.
Continue, sir.
For assuredly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, 'Be removed and be cast into the sea,' and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says."
Wow. Uh-huh.
"Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray."
Whatever things you ask. He said, whoever said, whoever. That means black, white, pink. A little boy, a little girl, if you can say, if you can be able to confess the Lordship of Jesus Christ over your life, you can be able to say. He said, whoever say, can you go back to Psalm verse 22, please?
So Jesus answered and said to them, "Have faith in God."
Uh-huh.
"For assuredly, I say to you, whoever says to this mountain..."
Did you hear that? Whoever say. Whosoever means what? Huh? Everybody, right? Including children. So teach a kid faith. Like my daughters, I teach them faith. I say, declare stuff. Don't ask me for present, declare. Say stuff. Teach them faith. Faith is not limited by anyone. He said, whosoever, black man, white man, pink man, born from a good family, a poor family, it doesn't matter. The moment you are born again, you have been catapulted. You are a different realm now. You are the realm of Jesus. And in this realm, whosoever, somebody say, whosoever. Ah, yeah, Kaza. That means every one of us here, there is hope. There's no need to compete with somebody else. There's no need to be envy and jealousy. There's no need. The Holy Ghost doesn't make you to be better than somebody. He makes you to become the best of you. So if you are praying, God, make me to be better, than God can never make you to be better than anybody. But God can make you to be the best of you. Who want to be the best of them? That's all you need. Be the best of you. Don't compete with anyone. But preparation is very, very important. Is there anyone here? Maybe you have been in a race. We have 100 meters race. 200. Yeah, oh, this one, GG, they go. How many race? When?
Yeah, it's around 100, 200 meters.
200 meters. I can see it on your leg. And then before he started, what did they say? Who's the guy? Is that the referee? What did he say?
On your mask.
Get set. Now, if you don't get set, you can't go far. Masite katabra hasita. On your mask, go. Talk to me. On your mask, go. You have to get set before you go. Before God uses you, God will make sure he sets you up. If you are not set, God can use. And if you run before the set, you are out of line. Tell them, don't run out of line tonight. Ladies do that when they run from different. I love the ladies, they are good. They are running different lines, and then he ended up out of the game. On your mask, get set. Who is set for billion? Oh God, sorry. Sorry, too fast. Get set before you go. So if you don't get set, I want to get you set tonight. So that no matter what, you know what you do. You can't even the spirit of prayer. No matter, you don't need to wait to find yourself in trouble to pray. Because whether you like it or not, trouble will come. If you don't look for it, it will look for you. Oh, yes. If you don't look for trouble, trouble will look for you. But when you look for him, kick him out. Tell him, kick the trouble out. Don't go under the bed and depress. Don't do that. I'm going to give you a medication tonight. Heavy dose. Hello. 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 Are you ready for medication? Yeah. I am here. I came from the factory. I'm loaded. So whosoever, we are getting set. Getting set. On your mask. On your mask. And I was watching teaching, and they're like, they're not like, what is my chewing gum?
Am I my mistake?
People pray, while they're praying, they're putting the, what do you call it, to make their lips, what do you call it? Lip balm or whatever, to make it smooth. That person, the man, I'm gonna get set. They are getting set. Have you seen people that want to do that? Say, can I get my lip balm? Only Christian people. Sometimes I wonder, did Christians know what Christianity is? And we are blaming God. Instead of we take our ignorance and make it right, and then we can get set and see the faithfulness of God. We say, God, why? We say, God, it's your fault. It's not his fault. Brothers and sisters, listen. For God so loved the world. Kissing Abraham, I want you to hear the heart of God. For God so loved you, he sent Jesus to die in your place. We actually know, how can a man love you someone and send someone to die in your place and you want to punish you? Then why did someone need to die for you? It does not make sense. The problem we have is we are learning this life and we are learning to understand who it is God. And if you don't know, my people perish because of what? Lack of this knowledge. Much information, spiritual knowledge. Do you believe that God loves you?
Yes.
If you believe that God loves you, lift your hand. Do you believe that he loves you 1 year? For how long? Do you believe that he loves you because you're a good person, you're an innocent? Do you love you guys too? Is God bigger than Prime Minister?
Yes.
Is God bigger than the richest man here on planet Earth? So imagine if you have a relationship with the richest man here on planet Earth, and then in any Ferrari, just Ferrari is your lunch. How do you treat that friend? Imagine some of you have access to Queen Elizabeth or Elizabeth. You'll be walking. Oh, Elizabeth is my friend. You'll be feel like you're important. And you'll be talking with you, some of you have the mistake to put in this Elizabeth one. But did you know that God is bigger than Elizabeth? I wish we know that though. We are longing for, say, who is your inspiration? Somebody looking for someone on YouTube. Their inspiration is little stuff. And God has given us Himself, Christ in us, the hope of glory. Believers, what else do we need when God has given us the best and the best? What is the problem with us? And why God cannot answer our prayer when He has given us the best? Is our prayer bigger than Jesus? Tell your neighbor tonight. Learn. On your mask, get set, go! Like running. The moment you are set, then there will be a setup. But if you are not set, nothing will happen. Whosoever said to this mountain, be removed and be what? Cast into the sea and does not doubt in the head. Oh, sorry. I think I need my glasses. But believe that what? So delicious.
That believe that those things He says will be done.
Yeah.
He will have whatever He says.
Whatever. Hello, whatever He says. Can I lift your hand and receive that? God said you can have whatever He says. I didn't say that. So, can we be able to have jealousy in the body of Christ? Can we? Can we have jealousy in the body of Christ? No. Because every one of us can have whatever they say. But ask yourself, ask your neighbor, what are you saying? After prayer, what are you saying? When your kidney is up, what are you saying? That's what you're saying. That is a cow one. That's not God. That's God there. And you receive whatever you see. Amen. Say, after tonight, I will be saying good stuff. No matter what. Say, neighbor, watch my back. I will be saying good stuff. Even though women are not nice to me, I will be saying good stuff about you. That's where the challenge is. Now, that one is mad. That's where we have the challenge. The challenge is to maintain the confession. That's where the challenge is. What are we saying? If we are honest with ourselves now, you find us. Now, if you're not saying with your mouth, what are you saying with your heart? Now, if you're not saying with your heart, what are you saying with your mind? We are all saying stuff. But tonight, you're going to be getting set, eh? Yeah, no, we are setting it up properly. In the name of Jesus. Uh-huh. Sometimes people are saying stuff. What they say in their mind and what they say in their mouth is different. Man saying something, mouth saying something, their heart saying something. So there's division between the heart and the mouth and the soul. Praise the Lord. As a praise the Lord, we try to cultivate the spirit of prayer. The spirit of prayer says one. They don't say two. They are the same. Amen. When Jesus says something, He meant it. So that's the spirit of prayer. We want to cultivate it before we pray. And then He says what? Verse
therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them.
When you believe that you receive it, when you pray, not after you pray. When we pray in the name of Jesus, I receive this. You believe that you receive it, and then you will have it. Don't believe after prayer. Believe when you are praying. Continue.
And whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive them.
Did you hear that? I was preaching. The preacher said, that's why I don't stand praying. I see that. whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against someone, We are talking about the adversary that stopped to open doors. See it here. The devil has been deep. Defeated. We try to find out why sometimes doors open but the enemy don't allow us to get in. He said, whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, not in your heart, that's why offense so bad. Which Christian know that? You can't afford it. It will stop you, it will hinder you for a long time until the land. You'll be fighting demon. The demon, all you have to do is learn to let it go. And when you let it go, you see the faithfulness of Jesus. So now, imagine somebody praying. Rakuse. We are praying to cultivate the spirit of prayer. And somebody don't like when they walk like this. Even kids, even children, they see adults. They don't like it, they walk away. I'm looking at these children, kids. They grow up, become having a stumbling block for their life. I said, are you all right? That's the thing I never know. How can a kid, you are children, how can you have a God and a grown-up man? He do not do that. No matter what, hide. If you don't know the word function, hide. You can't just say, a father, a mother become your enemy. We. And then, so they're growing up with all this problem with prayer. We want to learn. I want to be quiet and teach you today. So that when you get this, when you want, Jesus said, whosoever, whatever. Now, how come we sometimes we are not seeing those things come to pass? Then he said, whenever you are standing praying, if you have anything against someone, forgive. So that's where we are having some challenge. But we can correct it. Then we can get it right. Say, you're still alive. We can get it right. That's one thing about me. If you show me stuff, if I find it, I correct it. I don't just walk in ignorance. If you want to know how God thinks, look at his word. Don't try to ask your friends what they think. Your friends know nothing. They are blind as you are. Look at the word of God. Don't just focus somebody's idea. Open the Bible. See what the Bible says. Follow it. If you follow the Bible, you will not go wrong. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my word will never pass away. This word will make you successful. This word will keep you alive. This word, you can be surrounded in a fire. The thought that you're about to die, this the war on the world, that war will preserve you. Millions of people can gather, they will perish, but the word of God will preserve you. These things hold on this, because the hour we are living now, we demand us to know the word and rightly use the word no matter what. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, the hold on the word. Others bow to the first God. Daniel hold on the word. Others bow. And that sense it. The Lord, the same year now, this is a year we are facing. We are receiving men of God are bowing. And everybody have excuses. Why? There's no excuses. Only thing is fear. But that fear is rooted because of lack of the word of God. Because when you hold this, this man went to me to prophesy. I can feel it. Oh, Pumas, let me see. He said, don't, I want to teach. Hopefully, I have time. I'm going to have Holy Communion and I'm going to speak. All right? And then,
that your Father in heaven may also forgive you your trespasses.
Thank you. Continue.
But if you do not forgive, neither will your Father in heaven forgive your trespasses.
They hear that. That means prayer will not answer. You see, how simple it is. But we can get it right. That's why he cannot afford in the body of Christ dislike somebody. I was talking about somebody. He said, he was talking to me. He said, Papi, I don't go to church. Can you pray for me? Okay, I'll pray for you. I'm just waiting. And just because I want you guys to be sensitive. Papa P is a man When you're talking from here, I'm asking the Holy Spirit, who is this guy? Is that real? Is that this? Is that this? Before you say anything, he said, this man of God, the other, I don't want to know. I don't have respect for him. He said, listen. Stop now. It doesn't matter who you are. Whether they are good or not, the moment you open up your mouth, say you don't have a respect for any man, even a man of God, you are gone. Because who are you? How can you say you don't have respect for a man? Which God are you serving? Where did they get all this nonsense word to talk? The moment he said that you saw a sin, no demon in life can respect you. No poverty can respect you. No fear can respect you. The moment he said you don't have respect for a man, either you are not a born again. You see, there's some language you cannot say when you became a born again. You can't just say it. Because he can't function like demon in the house. No matter how much upset you are, you can't say you don't have respect for men. Now, if you say that, the Bible says your word is a seed. So what kind of seed do you expect to have? What kind of harvest do you expect to harvest? When you don't have respect for somebody, what do you get? So nothing will have respect for you. That's what you say. I say, I will not pray for you. Pray for yourself. Because people are hindrance to themselves. There's some word when you became a born again, you change your language. Because it's the language that limits our life, nothing else. You can't just see people say you don't have respect for them, whether they are good or not, that's none of your business. You can't say that. Who are you? Did the actual diamond care whether you respect him or not? Did he need their respect? He doesn't. But when you say that, you have put a full stop to your spiritual life. When you say that, and when you say, I don't like this, I don't like, you have put it, because in our kingdom, God never said that. For God so loved the world of drugs, world of alcohol, any kind of people, God loved them. And then he came to this family, and then he began to say exactly different from God. And then he said, God, you accept that because of your hurt or your injury. Everybody has been injured, man. You don't know that everybody has. But don't allow the injury to injure you. You have to get the word and stand up again. Amen. There's some word you can say. Imagine say, I don't like this family. I don't like it. And you're born again. How? How can you say that? You can't say words like that in the kingdom of God. Because when you say that you became an enemy to your creator, because your creator is a man that loved, this is his field. This is why he came. This is why he died on the cross. How can you hate why he died? And God will appoint him to deliver you. How? My people perish because of lack of knowledge. We want to cultivate the spirit of prayer. So when you go on your knees, before you pray, the angels are waiting to release the answer. You are learning. Are you learning? I want to teach you that. Is all right? Because I want after today, so that you finish this year strong. So when you step next year, you don't want to have closed doors. When you still say, door open, door open. Because you have cultivated the spirit of prayer. Because I have seen the lifestyle of Jesus. Whenever he said, Father, I thank you. Any prayer Jesus prayed, answered. Jesus has answered prayer. The Bible says, as he is, so are we in this world. If Jesus can have an answered prayer, all of us can have an answered prayer. But Jesus loved. Jesus never talked like that. He opened his word. The only people he was angry with is the Pharisees, not the sinners. It's the Pharisees, not sinners. The people that he challenging is the Pharisees. People that are hypocrites, that fighting against the truth. Not people that are born again like this. These are, Jesus said, they're like sheep without no shepherd. Amen. 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 Yeah. So we want to cultivate the spirit of prayer. So when sometimes our prayer, the doors are there, the things are there, it's sometimes it's lack of communication, the way we are communicating. You see an adult, a pastor, you see this one, a pastor, people make decisions. They are not led by the spirit. And then at the end of the day, can run, a wife can run, move away, a husband can move away, a man can move out of the church, move a different church. He can move the whole city you want to move. Nothing will change unless your heart is changed. It's not in the geographical location, it's in the spirit. Are you learning tonight? Amen. It seems like you're learning. You're too quiet. I never preach too quiet like this. I'm getting a bit scared, but okay. I get back my confidence. Amen. The Lord is good. So that's two things we're going to learn tonight, and then I'll pray. Because there's some people who are going to change their name tonight. They're never going to change their financial name. And God going to change their spiritual name. And God going to change their physical name. And God going to change their talking name. And God going to change your hearing name. And your eyes name. Your eyes has a name. That's what eyes for. Eyes of the spirit after tonight. Are you ready? Yes. Romans 8:14. Oh, you are learning it, huh? I love tonight. I just want to study the word. I want to break the word down. Romans 8:14.
For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are sons of God.
As many as are led by the Spirit, these are the mature sons of God. Because not every born again. We want to cultivate the spirit of prayer. So if your prayer is going to be effective, the spirit of God has to lead you. You can't lead yourself and expect God to answer you. Hello? Does that make sense? The Bible says, as men are led by the spirit, these are the mature, they are youths. These are not born again. Born again are technons. We call them technons. Technons are people that are born again. It may be born by a mom or a daddy, but it may be raised by an auntie. So you think like auntie, you don't think like mom. Do you hear what I'm saying? Somebody can be birth to a child, but his cousin or his uncle can raise that person. That person can may not think like the biological daddy, you know, think like the uncle. Yeah. If uncle like Subaru, that young man will be like this Subaru. If the father, the biological father like Van, like six sisters. He will not. Now the Bible says, as men are led by the Spirit, these are the mature sons of God. These are not people, they are not moved by joy. The reason why to live by the Spirit is listen. You may plan things. Like a lady that planned, a police lady was in Nigeria, she was doing her police, arresting all this. And the people that he used to arrest before get angry with her. So they went to her home to steal everything from her. And then, so when she fit in her spirit to pray in the Holy Ghost, she was on a traffic ward. And then when she was doing traffic ward, he said, she was makataka-taka, instead of controlling the light, she was praying. So the criminals came to her home, pack everything and leave it there. Some of us here, the criminal came, they will pack everything and take it home because we are not led by the Spirit. Sometimes you can make plan this. You never ask the Spirit. Like, all the meeting will go. I can just have a day go. I can't just fly. We have to ask, is that the right time to go? But some of us, you just make a plan, this is what I'm doing, that's it. And eventually we start. And we blame God. God never leads us. If God doesn't lead you to do stuff, when you call him, he will not answer for that. God can never answer what he never asks you to do. Always know that. And the Bible says that when you begin to grow, cultivating the spirit of prayer, You don't just do things you want to do. As men are led by the Spirit, these are matured. The matured sons of God. These are people, they don't just do stuff. They ask the Lord, I want to travel here. I want to go here. Is that good? Because you may have plan, and then you find yourself in a mess. And then you wonder, I wish I didn't go there. I wish, if some of you can feel the feeling, you can feel like something is not right. But it's, oh, we just want to do that. But you know that it's not right. And from when that feeling is there, you're going to get stuck, whether you like it or not. That's why we must be led by the Spirit. And that's why the Spirit operates us, to help us. Like what's going to happen on Friday? What's going to happen in here? We already know that. You're led. 2021, we already know that. How are we going to prevail? Before COVID-19 shows up, why every member, we have almost thousands of people all over the world, why every our member, none of them have COVID-19? What happened? Why? Before COVID-19, I already told you that these are oil of what? Fire. And none of them, as long as this oil will touch, everything changed. Knowing what is ahead, preparing against it, or your minds get set. You don't get set before you go. Many people on their minds going with that set. Hello? Are you learning tonight? So that's why you don't just travel, don't just do stuff. And then we end up stuck. On weekends, sometimes I can stay on weekends. No sleep. But I'm fresh. Or I can sleep. But it's what the Lord wants me to do. Because we want to help someone. Now there's a man from Fiji. Remember that man that was, he came with a family. He was a Hindu man, right? He was a Hindu. They came from Auckland. Do you remember that man in the city? They came from Auckland, he left the wife in the first place, and they would have to command the man back to the wife. Right? You guess who was there? Yeah. Now, his sister has sis in Fiji. Remember as I told her that her sister. Now see what happened after her prayer. Is that?
Thank you, Papa, for blessings for me and my family. We are so, so blessed. My sister who had a cyst is healed and the cyst is no more. She went for the scan today. Pastor Tele came today and removed all idols and blessed our house. Glory to Jesus.
No, don't clap yet. We're going to do that on Friday. What I'm trying to say, we are here, but the cyst was here in Fiji. When I spoke to the man, what happened to his sister? Or some, we can still be here. We can still be here, seeing what God doing, and walk in darkness. And when somebody came all the way from Auckland, standing here as a point of contact, because he was on your mask, he was set, and the Holy Ghost performs. Because when you're not set, it doesn't matter how much you cry, the Holy Ghost will not perform. The kingdom of God is not a mirage. It's said, it's normal. It's said, the kingdom that you can live. If no, that's what Bible said. God showed his ways to Moses. But the power, the miracle, he showed it to the children of Israel. Why? They are not interested. They are interested in miracle. They are interested in who can back jobs, all this. But they are not interested to know the ways of God. Because to know the ways of God demand times, and demand sacrifice, and demand pain, and demand killing yourself every day. But men don't want to do that. Because we have 1 million questions for God. Why? And God can answer you because we are too small to understand what God is doing. Imagine Abraham asking God, why did I need to kill Isaac? Or imagine Jesus asking God, why should I go on the cross of Calvary? But they believe God. They never question God. They believe him. Jesus said, Are you sure you're gonna raise me up? I'm just a bit curious. I'm just asking, you know. I mean, you can ask that. Say, in 3 days, are you sure 3 days? Oh my gosh. What about one day? God, are you sure? Are you true?
You don't have those stories, but we have it every day.
But we have the word of God to help us not to ask those silly questions. But we still continue to do it. Because we think we know God better than God. Are you hearing me? The problem is what they are not led by the Spirit. When you led by the Spirit, you realize that God loves you more than you love yourself. And when he put you on the cross, it's for you to go on top. That's the reason for that. Now, a man came from Auckland. He was set to be free. And then he just came here for himself and his wife. God picked up his sister that had cysts. She couldn't be able to have a baby because that in blood had done or whatever. But while he was here, my sister, look at her. Went for a scan. The cyst is no longer. With a word. With a word. With a word. I said, with a word. I said, it's just a word. The doctor been treating for years, they couldn't get it done. But one word can change it. Do you know that one word on Friday or one word tonight can change your life properly? Just a word. But that word will not work. If you have any grudge, if you have unforgiveness, you have to let it go. And then the Bible says, as men are led by the Spirit, put on. Why my mouth sounds like this? Sounds like Australia. Can I bring it to New Zealand, please?
For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are sons of God.
Continue.
For you did not receive the spirit of bondage again to fear, but you received the spirit of adoption, by whom we cry out, Abba, Father.
There never, God is our Father. We cry who? Abba, Father. Papa, Papa, Daddy, Daddy. Continue.
The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God.
That is big. That we are, the Spirit bears witness that we belong to whom? Come on, talk to me, church. We belong to whom? We are the children of God. Say, I am the child of God. That is actually big if you have revelation about it. To be a child of God is bigger than to be a child of a king. To be a child of God is bigger than be a child of a billionaire or the richest man on planet Earth. To be a child of God means everything God has is belongs to you. So how can we have everything and complain? Because we are not led by the Spirit. So we are led by family, led by job, led by business, and eventually, maybe in 10 years, maybe in 5 years, maybe in 2 years, we get stuck. Mark what I'm saying. We already tried those things. We will start. Then you realize all we say. Are you hearing me? Whether you like it or not, Jesus said, apart from me, you can do nothing. God will allow you to try, but eventually it will start. And then you realize that the word of God works. We've been there. Remember, I know our Father is even there. The word of God can be compromised. So we're going to learn 2 things tonight. We're going to help you to be effective. 2 Christians. And you find your way where you belong and where you're going to catapult. And when you do that, your life will be blessed. Bible says, the Spirit himself bears witness that we belong to God. We are children of God. Continue. Cultivating the spirit of prayer. When we say cultivating the spirit of prayer, we are not talking about praying because everybody can pray. But that prayer may not have substance if you don't have the root. Confession without connection is noise. And we don't want to be connected properly. Amen. And then when we pray, there will be a voice, not an echo. Then never say, I am a voice. Yeah, continue.
And of children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If indeed we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together.
That means when we go through some challenge, there's another side. There's a challenge, there's a suffering side, and there's a glory side. Who is ready for glory side? But only Christian people want only the glory side. But before the glory side, you have to go through the, come on, talk to me, suffering side. So many people don't like the suffering side. They want the glory side. Suffering side is to build your character. Glory side is to show you, to help you to show up. Your character cannot build in glory. Your character can only build when you go through some suffering. And God will make sure every one of us go through it. Either you go through or you jump through.
And when you jump through, you come back again. You have to go through. And then you jump again, you come back again, you have to go through and learn. Amen. Praise the Lord. Are you hearing me tonight? Okay, continue. I'd like to get this and then we're out.
For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us.
The Lord is saying what you are going through right now is nothing. Tell them it's nothing. For what is about to take place before the end of this year, can you receive it? Can you receive it? Can you take it? Can you take it? Clap your hand and receive that. The Lord says, yes, you may be going through some challenge, you may be going through some challenge, if you can persevere, if you can persevere, if you can persevere, what is about to reveal is bigger than what you're going through. Can you believe the word of God? What is about to reveal, if you can believe God and hang on and stay on and focus and don't be deserted and focus in prayer, focus in the things of God, keep on sowing, keep on giving, keep on loving, keep on doing the things you do. God said, what gonna be revealed? Became bigger than Japan. Is there anyone that believes the word of God? Shout hallelujah. I love Jesus. These are the things when you see, you don't want to give up. Continue.
For the earnest expectation of the creation eagerly waits for the revealing of the sons of
the
God.
The creation are waiting for us. The earnest expectation of the creation. They are eagerly waiting for the sons to manifest. But the sons are they're not paying attention, that they focus on their pain. And bam, God tries to tell this pain is for glory. This pain you're going through right now, you're not going to suffer for a long time. It's a while. But there's going to be another side. And the earnest expectation of the creation, waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. Tell them, when are we going to manifest? After this teaching. Continue.
For the creation was subjected to futility, not willingly, but because of him who subjected it in hope.
Yes, sir. Continue.
Because the creation itself also will be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God.
The creation is in pain. You see the climate change, or what they call it, earthquake. They are in pain. They are waiting to, because they can't be born again. So now we are born again. They're waiting for us to deliver them. So the only way the world is going to change is when we begin to speak blessings. Not like all this climate change you try to do. Those things, it's not climate change. It's cause. The creation is in pain. Before the climate change shows up, look at the Bible was there. So the creation waiting for us to speak blessing over them. Speak blessing. When we speak blessing over that cat is blessed. That business is blessed. That marriage is blessed. When you open up your mouth and speak blessing, something happens. They are waiting for us to manifest. Lift your hands. I will manifest tonight. Say, I will manifest. Say, it has been too long. Say, enough is enough. In Jesus' name. Continue.
For we know that the whole creation groans and labors with birth pains together until now.
Until now, they are groaning. Hey! Chickens and things, and they are groaning. Look at the world, it's in a mess. People are giving up anyhow. They are waiting for the Son to speak a word. But the Son that can't speak a word is the Son that be led by the Spirit. These are the skills of God. These are the people that can decree, and when they decree, God will honor their word. Because they are led by God. So if God can't lead me, how can you speak a word and it happens? So if I lead myself and expect God can never authorize the things he never started. Okay, let's go. Put a pause here. We're going to come back. We're going to go to two believers tonight, and then we're going to finish there. We're going to have the spirit of Martha. By the way, we're going to change your name tonight from Martha to Mary. We're changing names. There's a spirit of Martha. Some of the spirit of Martha. Come on, open up your mouth and say, the spirit of Martha and the spirit of Mary. Luke chapter 10, verse 1. Tonight going to be, your name will be changed tonight. We have been having Martha for a long time. Luke chapter 10, verse 41. Oh, my Satan.
And Jesus answered and said to her, Martha, Martha, you are worried and troubled about many things.
Did you hear that? The spirit of Martha is a spirit the devil have released in this season. Martha is a spirit of worry. Okay, put another translation, maybe NIT or the brother.
But the Lord said to her, "My dear Martha."
My dear, my God, love Martha. Okay. Tell him, my dear Martha. Not your name. Is that Martha? No, Martha. My dear Martha, you are worried and upset. You preach about that, they are upset. You preach about that forgiveness, they are upset. It's a Martha spirit. Unless you preach what they want, they are happy. How? It's a Martha. Now, Jesus was in the house. What else Martha need? Tell me, what else did Martha need? What else did he need? He has the author of life in his home. Marcus Abraham. So the same thing will have miracles, signs and wonders, and people are not seeing. And when they find a place in a place of Martha situation, they realize their life is a mess. Jesus is in the house. We are talking about, you see, what's happening in the church today, what happened in the world today, it doesn't start today. It starts today. Yeah, back. So when you don't read the Bible, you think that what's happening? What happened in the church is not, it's not a new thing. Jesus is in the house. Can you become better than Jesus? Can you do better than Jesus? Who made the whole world? Who made the whole world? Jesus. The money Mother need, who made it? Jesus. The food he need, who made it? Jesus. The Prince of Peace, who? Jesus. Everything he need, who? Jesus. Guess who was in her house? Jesus. Guess who was worried? This is an issue we have all over the world, the body of Christ. Everything we need is in our house. We are still worried. We are still angry. We are still upset. How can you have Jesus and have upset? What do you need that he can give to you? So what's the problem? Their vision has been removed. Martha's vision has been removed. That's why you need to listen to what I'm saying. We share the word for you, for what is ahead. You will see what's going to happen next year. People will fade away like chicken. Mark what I'm saying? People will fade away like chicken. It's not here. It's not what you can do. The rest is not how strong you are. The rest is God that shows mercy. So if you don't know how to get the mercy from the Lord, and that mercy is the word. Now, Jesus was not concerned about matter. Jesus said, "My dear matter, why are you are worried?" Okay, let's bring it on from verse 40. Let's see what Martha said to Jesus. Are we ready tonight? Are we ready? Tell them, are you ready? Yes. Look at them on their eyeballs. Are you ready? Yes. Bring it to verse 40. Bring it to yeah. What happened?
But Martha was distracted.
What happened? Read it again.
But Martha was distracted.
Read it again.
But Martha was distracted.
Read it again.
But Martha was distracted.
Distraction is what killed many believers. Distraction is not necessarily wrong things. You can be distracted testing your best friend. You can be distracted testing your wife at the wrong time. Distraction is not actually necessarily doing the wrong things. You can be doing the right thing at the wrong time. We call it distraction. Because Martha was not doing wrong thing. Martha was distraction. The moment you get distracted, what community have born? You make born again, get distracted. Born again, that focus. But after COVID-19, they're all distracted. And then when you're distracted, you find somebody to blame. You find mom or daddy or anybody to blame. And that's exactly what happened to Martha. One thing about the Bible is everything you're going through, go to the Bible. Don't go to friends. Don't go to anybody. Look at the Bible. Find out where you are. And then find out how can I correct it. And if you don't correct it and hear the God and hear the word and continue, you see that the word of God have no ignorance for it. Now, but Bible said, but Martha was distracted by the what? Big what? Dinner. Big dinner is all right or wrong? We need some big dinner, my brothers, this one. We need some big dinner sometimes, or. But big dinner, when the creator of the universe is in their house, big dinner
that when miracles, signs and wonders happening here. Big dinner when we see glory manifest and somebody get distracted by Monica didn't say hi. Oh, that usher didn't like me. She pushed me out. Nobody loved me. When you see miracles, signs and wonders are happening in your midst, people's life have been transformed. You focus on the big dinner. Lift your hand and say, no more big dinner tonight. Better eat small. My son is big dinner. Demon tremble at your presence. Big dinner was a problem. Martha loved big dinner. Tell them, am I talking to you or something? I love the word of God. They love the word of God. I didn't write this. I'm just. So look at this. Don't look at me. I can see some of your eyes like. Did I put that here? I'm innocent. Yeah. So don't just look at me and say, Papa, I'm talking about, I didn't write this. Please, I didn't. Just happened to be there for you and I, so that we can bless our big dinner, have a lesser dinner. Martha was distracted by a big dinner. Lift your hand and say, I will not be distracted by a big dinner. Some people now going for lunch instead of empowerment class. Some people now going to go for stuff instead of a prophetic prayer. While we are makatakata, they are eating barbecue. And when the enemy barbecue their back, they said, Jesus said, we are barbecue. When others, we are praying. As men are led by barbecue will heal you. But barbecue can't. So we blame God for our ignorance. So we blame everything on God. We never take responsibility for our actions. So we try to blame anybody. This, there's no place you cannot afford to blame anybody for your life. If you are born again. Martha was distracted by a big dinner, not by Mary. But guess what? Martha was distracted by a big dinner. She was preparing.
She came to Jesus and said, Lord, doesn't it seem unfair to you that my sister just sits here while I do all the work? Tell her to come and help me.
Exactly like us. Teach me, Lord, to know your ways. To know. You see, he went to tell Jesus off. Now he's telling Jesus off. It's unfair. Don't take care. He's a healer. He's your savior. He's the reason why he came for you. People, I believe you're hearing somebody's testimony. You don't care. You're not ready for your life. You're just kids. You will learn. Because this is not a game. While you're rolling that eyes and rolling that ears, the Holy Ghost is watching you. You will roll it. And when you're tired, your kid will begin to roll it on you. Then you realize the kingdom of God is not for a place like that. We all mess up. We are not. The blood of Jesus cleansed us. Brought us from this world called the Noah's Ark. Noah's Ark. Good. Different kind of animals. Stinky animals. Smelly animals. Fish. Everything inside. And then God blows it. I don't like it because you have to put up with it. If you jump out of the ark, you jump inside the water. You have to stay in the ark to be saved. Now look at Martha. Martha said, don't take care. Why can't you tell my sister to come and help me? Why can't you? He's telling his Messiah off. He rebuked his miracle. He telling his life off. The one that came to change his story or her story is the one he telling, why can't you? And then let's see the response of Jesus. That's what he says to her.
But the Lord said to her, my dear Martha.
Jesus was so kind.
You were worried and upset over all these details.
Yes.
There is only one
thing. There is only one thing worth being concerned about.
Mary has discovered it, and it will not be taken away from her.
Where was Mary? At the feet of attention to the world. Mary was attention to the world. He says, what you need. You don't need big dinner. You don't need big dinner. You don't need big lunch. You need the world. And your sister have got it. And nobody, whether you like it or not, whether you mock him or not, whether you tease him or not, nobody can take it away from her. When God bless you, nobody can stop it. When I read this, Jesus tried to show the problem of Mary, the problem of Martha. The problem of Martha is not Mary. The problem we have is not nobody. The problem is big dinner. That big dinner may be your ambitions, maybe what you want to do, maybe all these things, and you don't want to hear. And one day you're going to get worried and get upset, and then you're going to blame Mary. But Mary is a man, that a woman. Pay attention to the world. She may not be perfect. He may not be perfect, but he loves the world. And Jesus said, nobody can take it away from him. Nobody can take it away. See, imagine going to Jesus complaining. Jesus was not angry about Mary. Jesus was actually concerned about Martha. Why are you doing this? That's why when you get hurt, get broken, that God will move by your blood. God is not through that. See how the word of God works. So what was the problem here? It's a spirit. Go back verse 40. It's a spirit. The spirit of distraction has been released in the body of Christ today. And you can see people distracted. And it's a matter spirit. And when that spirit comes upon you, you focus on a big dinner. Big dinner, maybe your business, maybe your car, maybe lunch, maybe families. That's your big dinner. You forget about the Lord that saved your soul. So you forget about where he brought you from anymore. So you're focused on now, that's me. But you will learn. Because Martha learned. Martha was on the big dinner. Jesus never rebuked Mary. Jesus said, Martha, you are prepared. She was there. He came to Jesus and said, well, don't you see that it's unfair that a puppy became a billionaire? Don't you see your fear? That may have a private jet. Because where were you then? We are focusing on a big dinner. And somebody here be praying. Do you want to pray now? I don't have time for prayer. It's not working. They are praying because it's not working because it's working. It's working in the spirit. God doesn't use their ears. He doesn't use their eyes. When you pray, it's working. God rearranging things. So you are thinking that in your flesh, you can accomplish stuff. And the Bible tells you, flesh accomplish nothing. But don't forget about the Bible. Don't forget about everything he said. I know what I'm doing. As men are led by the spirit, it's as the sons of God. No, I can do all things through Christ Jesus. No, you abandon me and my word abandon. You just do. And then you think that after you're doing the right thing, God will honor that. That's what Martha thinks. Preparing a big dinner is all wrong. It's not wrong. She has a wonderful idea so that Jesus can eat before minister. But Jesus didn't come there to eat. Jesus came so that he can draw from him. And Jesus didn't bother with her food. That food can be $1 million a month you give to the Lord. That can be anything that if God is not first place, Jesus would. So when you read this, what are you going to do tonight? You're going to change from the address of Martha, run to the address of Mary. Pay attention to the world. When you do that, when you open up your mouth, God will pay attention to you. You have cultivated the spirit of prayer. A man that pays attention to his word is a God. The same God that he pays attention to his word will pay attention to your word. This is where we blessed. Because the moment we see the things of God, we treasure it, we love it, we honor it. And when we say something, God honors that. When I see your life in this year, God restore everything that enemy has stolen. And you finish your battle in 2024, 21, with that stress, this is it. Don't become matter, become man. See, I'm teaching, I don't want to preach, I want you to hear. So you can know the word of God is simple for us. This is Jesus. You have Jesus and looking for beginning. You have Jesus and looking for things. When you have Jesus, you have everything. The reason why Martha didn't get it, Martha was in the flesh. Martha was doing flesh stuff. But Mary was in the spirit. And Mary cultivated it. That if I can get the word can get me. Abandon me and my word abandon you. Whatever you ask, it shall be so. Are you hearing me?
We declare her Mary now. Come on, somebody. Do you believe in the Lord? Give more glory to me. Give more glory. Give more glory. Somebody shout hallelujah. Now I look at you. I prophesy to you over your family, over your marriage, over your business, over your finance, that as God has changed her name, may your financial name be changing, may your business name be changing, may your physical name be changing. Whatever that be long time, I pray, I curse in the name of Jesus. I release your destiny, I release your family, I release your business, I release your career in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that from tonight, you're not gonna function like everyone else, you're gonna be led by the Spirit. Clap your hand and pray. I feel like something has been released tonight. Job have you released. Business have you released. Wash Abraham's